Good morning, children. I welcome you all, 5th grade, for the visual classes conducted by Eva. Myself, Mrs. Gauri, I'll be teaching English this year. Let us begin the day with the first lesson as a poem, right? The clothes line. I want all of you to open your textbook, the page which consists of the poem, the clothes line. Right? Let us begin the day with the poem, the clothes line. The poet who wrote this poem is Caroline Druid Cole. This is the poet who wrote this poem. Before starting the poem, I just want you people to imagine yourself that how will be the movement of the air? How will be the movement of the clothes when the air blows? Right? You have seen, right? Your mother washed clothes and the clothes were hung on the rope with the help of pegs and clips. And if the breeze blows or if the wind blows, how will be the movement of the air? I want all of you to recall or imagine yourself the movement of the clothes. And second thing is that I want all of you to imagine what would happen if the cloth have its own life. What would happen if the cloth have its own life? These two things I want you to recall and imagine yourself before starting the poem. Now, can we begin the poem, children? Let me read the poem. Hand in hand, they dance in a row, hither and thither and to and fro, flip, flap, flop, and away they go. Fluttering creatures as white as snow, like rescue horses they caper and prance. Like fairy tale witches, they wildly dance, rounded in front but hollow behind. They shiver and skip in the merry march ring. One I saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly till she was free. Then, leaving pegs and clothes lying behind her, she flew like a bird and no one could find her. I saw her gleam like a sail in the sun, flipping and flapping and flopping for fun. Nobody knows where she now can be, hidden in a ditch or drowned in the sea. She was my handkerchief not long ago, but she will never come back to my pocket, I know. Written by Caroline Druid Cole. So, in this poem, the speaker of this poem is the poet himself. Once the poet will watch the movement of the clothes. Once he will be watching the clothes which were hung on the rope, right? Which were hung on the rope with the help of pegs and clips. He will be watching excitedly. Which season he will watch? It is in the month of March. He will start watching the movement of clothes due to the blowing of air. The soft movement of air is called as breeze, right? The first movement of air is called wind. You all know, children. Now, hand in hand, they dance in a row, hither and thither and to and fro. So you can see in a row, all the clothes are moving. The movement of the clothes is comparing to the dancing, right? Hither and thither. What do you mean by hither and thither? What do you mean by hither and thither? Hither and thither means moving towards the direction of a place. Means the movement of the clothes towards the direction of the air. So that movement is compared to the words are hither and thither. This comparison is made. The movement of clothes towards the direction of air. That words what the poet is used is hither and thither. And to and fro. Can you see, children? Did you observe? Can you see the movement of the clothes? It is moving towards and frontwards. To and fro. Frontwards and backward direction. This movement is called as to and fro movement. Flip, flap, flop, and away they go. Have you observed when the wind blows, you can see the sound of the clothes movement also. The clothes movement also will make sound, will cause a sound. That sound, flip, flap, flop, or the sound made by the clothes movement. Fluttering creatures as white as snow. What do you mean by fluttering? Fluttering means moving lightly and weakly. Like rescue horses, they caper and prance. So the clothes are moving lightly and quickly due to the movement of breeze, right? This movement, the poet is compared to the movement of horse. Caper. Caper means a short jumping or dancing movement is called as caper. The horse short jumping. So the poet is comparing the movement of the clothes to the horse movement. Horse short jumping. He is comparing that. Comparison is made. The clothes movement are restive. Restive means restless. It is moving continuously because of the wind. It is moving to and fro continuously without any stop, without any rest. This movement is compared to the horse jump. That is called as caper. What do you mean by prance? Prance means move with a high step. This word normally you will use in a dance, in the dancing this. But here the poet is imagining that himself, that his clothes are his whole life. So for that reason, the clothes movement are compared to the dancing steps. Like fairy tale witches, they widely dance, rounded in front but hollow behind. They shiver and skip in a merry march wind. And also the poet is comparing the movement of the dancing movement of the clothes to the fairy tale witches. You have heard about fairy tales, folk tales, right children? But in that, how the witches will dance very widely, right? Even this movement also is very wide. It is this quick movement without any rest. It is resting. And they shiver and skip in the merry March wind. So in the month of March, the poet is observing all this. One I saw dancing excitedly, struggling so wildly till she was free. So when he was watching all this, suddenly, excitedly, the poet, one I saw. Who is the speaker in this poem, in this slide? I means poet. He is the speaker. So he will watch one cloak moving very strongly, excitedly, at the same time struggling to be free. Already I told in the beginning itself, imagine yourself, the cloth will have its own life, right? Imagine, if it would have a own life, nobody are interested to get hung in the, with the help of pegs, with the help of clip, right? Even that cloth also, it is struggling to be free. It is struggling to be free. Then leaving pegs and clothes behind her, she flew like a bird and no one could find her. So the cloth, one of the cloth was, it was already, it set free from the pegs and clips. It started flying. What the comparison is made, the movement of the cloth will set free, that comparison is made to a bird. How the bird is flying like that, one of the cloth, it set free from the clips and pegs, it start moving in the air, it start flying in the air. I saw her gleam like a sail in the sun, flipping and flapping and flopping for fun. What do you mean by sail? Sail is a homophone word, children. You have two meanings. One meaning of that word sail means the boat is sailing in the water. In this poem, what do you mean by the word sail? In this poem, the sail means piece of fabric spread on a mast towards the wind to catch the wind. That is the meaning of sail. So the one of the cloth is flying in the air. In the comparison is made like a bird. It is sailing. It is sailing towards the wind and making flipping, flapping and flopping sounds. Nobody knew where she now can be, hidden in a ditch or drowned in the sea. The poet doesn't know where the cloth is flying, whether it is hidden in a ditch or drowned in the sea. She was my handkerchief not long ago, but she will never come back to my pocket, I know. So the poet, he is confirmed. He already knew. What he knew? The cloth which was flying is nothing but the poet's handkerchief. It will never come back to him. Where the handkerchief will fly, where it will move, whether it will move and ditch in a sea, ditch in a ditch, hit in a ditch or drown in the sea, he doesn't know. And the handkerchief, poet's handkerchief, will never come back to the poet again. She, the word last, she in the line, she refers to poet's handkerchief in his life. So summary of the poem is, once the poet Carole brilliant coat. You will be watching excitedly. The clothes hung on the rope with the help of the pegs and clips. The movement of the clothes due to the strong movement of wind or breeze, for slow movement of air, that is breeze, he will be watching the movement of the clothes excitedly. He will compare the movement of the clothes to a bird and flipping, flapping, flopping sounds, and he will, at last he will see that one of the clothes was set free from the peg. It starts flying in the air. The comparison is made to a bird, and he knew that the cloth is struggling to set free. When it set free, it starts flying, and the poet knew that it will be, he don't know whether where the cloth is flying, whether it will hit in a ditch or drown in the sea. But he already knew that that cloth will not come back to him again. Which is that cloth which was flying, which was set free? It was poet's handkerchief. So I want all of you to read the poem once, children. Today's letters we have completed, clothes like. I want all of you to read the poem, understand the poem. Thank you.